For now, though, what I want to make sure that we get to is this issue of how you get to a nation. Okay, so that's going to be one of our major themes. And I don't mean it teleologically, just to stress. I don't mean like why Ukraine had to be, because that's a terrible question. As soon as you're in the world of why a nation had to be, you've obliviated, you've eliminated, you've erased all human agency in the whole story. Right? If I'm able to say right now, like from the pulpit, Ukraine had to exist, then we're removing everything which makes history interesting, right? The human choices along the way people saw the circumstances they were in, what people thought was possible, what they thought they were doing, and what they sometimes even did, all that goes away. If I can say, oh, there had to be America, or there had to be Russia, or there had to be China, there didn't have to be any of these things. We can explain how they came into being, but what we can't say, and this is what Putin does, we can't say that it's predetermined. As soon as we say it's predetermined, this is no longer a history class, it's in some kind of, we're in some kind of exercise in, you know, applied physics or something. Okay, but the bad, so there's a bad answer to why, you know, to where history comes from, which is that things had to be the way they are. And that bad answer is closely related to this war. Because Putin gave that bad answer in July of 2021 when he wrote an incredibly long, for a politician, not long for you guys, an incredibly long essay about what he called On the Historical Unity of Russia and Ukraine. And his bad answer is that things are the way they are because they had to be this way, basically. Right? Russia and Ukraine have always been together, and if they're not together, that's the result of alien, non-historical forces. This is really important, by the way, because when a tyrant makes an argument about how history has to be, then some of the forces that are actually resident in history get classified as being ahistorical or non-historical or exotic or alien. Right? So in Putin's telling you the story, all the Lithuanian stuff and all of the Polish stuff and all of the Jewish stuff, for that matter, all the things which aren't about Christianity or Russia are now suddenly exotic, alien, foreign. They're not really history. They're the things that have to be removed so that history can go the way that it's supposed to go. And that is precisely a rationale for war. In fact, it is the rationale for this war, because the argument for this war is that Ukrainians don't know who they really are because they've been polluted by all this Polish stuff or Lithuanian stuff or Habsburg stuff, or maybe more laterally Ukrainian European Union stuff or American stuff. So you have to peel away all this artificial things to get down to who they really are. And they may not know who they really are, and that's tragic. And we have to apply enough violence so that they can understand who they really are, right? And once you're in that way of seeing things, then of course the war makes perfect sense to you, right? And so the way that history is presented has an integral connection with the decision to make a war, and also to the way that a war seems to make sense while it's going on, right? While it's going on to the people who are taking part of it. So.
Сотни лет это была русская земля. Русские ее обустраивали и проливали за нее кровь. Пока в 91-м году ради власти кучка предателей не развалила Великую империю. В городе действует комендантский час. Выходить на улицу можно только с 10 до 12 и только на своей улице. На руках обязательно носить белые повязки. На каждом доме должно быть написано по-русски, сколько там находится человек. Мы спасем эту страну. Выбора нет. Либо они, либо мы. А кто не согласен? Что ж.
Oh!
беспокойтесь. Вы все нормальные. А это грязь. И мы здесь, чтобы очистить вас от этой грязи.
Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say, who murdered three. Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where a dead man called out for his love to flee? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where a necklace of hope side by side with me? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree where I told you to run so we'd both be free? Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree? They strung up a man, they say we murdered three. Strange things did happen here, no stranger would it be if we met at midnight in the hanging tree. Are you coming to the tree? And call out for his love to feel. Strange things that happen to the stranger. At midnight in the hanging tree.
Вони прагнуть паніки і хаос, хочуть знищити нашу енергосистему, вони безнадійні. Друга мішень – це люди. Спеціально обрали такий час, такі цілі, щоб завдати якнайбільше шкоди.
Чи продовження попиток проведення на нашій території терактів, відповіді зі сторони Росії будуть жорсткими і по своїм масштабам будуть відповідати уровню угроз, створюваних Російською Федерацією. Ні у кого не должно быть никаких в этом сомнений.